Hello, hello. Welcome back. My name is Lindsay Dollinger, and I want to talk to you today about a topic that is super dear to my heart, just because it is something that I obviously have done. Once we get started talking, you'll understand what I mean by that. But it's something that I have done and that I really recommend to literally pretty much everyone to do. And it's start a side business. Whether or not you are currently in a business or not, I really would love to encourage you to start something that is your own. So what I mean by your own is if you are in network marketing, direct sales, social selling, affiliate marketing, selling something that is not actually yours, either a service that you created or products that you are creating, I want to encourage you to add something that is your own, that you don't have to rely on anyone else's rules, anyone else's products, anyone else's inventory, anyone else's anything in order to be able to do, because you have full ownership, you have full control over it. And I truly believe as well that even if you are completely content with your full-time job, adding other streams of income is an extremely smart thing to do. Anyway, we're going to dive into the reasons that I'm saying this. So these are in no particular order. If you know me and you know my podcast style, my video style, I don't really like to be like, this one's the most important and this one's the least important. So this is just a list of things that I came up with on reasons why I believe that creating your own products and services, business in general, while also navigating your full-time job, network marketing, whatever that is for you, is extremely powerful. Okay, so reason number one, and this is a huge reason why I got started in network marketing actually to begin with, but then also added my own, you know, business coaching, my planner and tracker that I created, different programs, services, offerings. The number one reason that, and again, not in any particular order, but the first reason that we're going to talk about is it allows you to unleash your creative potential. So we know that relying on your network marketing products, I'm going to use that as an example, definitely has limitations, right? So you're not coming up with the products yourself. You're not usually deciding prices. Like, there's always a minimum price that you get to charge. It's not, usually you can choose an upper price, especially with, like, I'm thinking of clothing back when I sold LuLaRoe. There was a minimum price that we had to charge, but you could charge more if you wanted. The majority of people charged manufacturer retail MRV. Anyway, charge the certain amount that you were supposed to charge. Okay. So there are definitely limitations in relying solely on your network marketing products. And really the only creativity that I got to experience when I was solely doing network marketing was creativity of my marketing, like my own personal marketing, my personal brand that I got to build, and also how I was going to run my team, what I wanted that to look like. But everything else was pretty defined by my company, right? You have your contract that you sign when you're in network marketing. Policies and procedures is what it's called in most places. And they're the list of rules that you have to follow. Same thing with affiliate marketing. Same thing if you're working with brands. There's going to be, most likely, if you're doing it in a professional capacity, some sort of contract, some sort of guidelines that you get to follow in order to make sure that, you know, you're representing the brand in the way they want you to represent it. Same thing with your full-time job. Most likely you have a contract for your full-time job. This is how you are supposed to behave. You know, I'm a full-time teacher, so teachers especially, we have a very strict, you know, codes of conduct, things we're allowed to do, things we're not allowed to do. And so for me, one of the things that I was really craving was the ability to express myself and show my individuality, show my creativity, and really build something that was like 100% mine, right? And so that's going into reason number two, is you get to build a unique brand identity, AKA your personal brand. And you can do this as well with network marketing, but again, everything is still tying back into some sort of product that is not your own, that you didn't create. Someone else created that, right? So the cool thing when you start adding in your own products and or services is that you are building a unique brand around them. And so your personal brand, and this is not the episode to dive really deep into personal branding, but I think personal branding is so fun. I have loved playing around with and really deciding my personal brand. And through that process, deciding really who I wanted to be. So it was kind of like, like a rebirthing, for lack of a better word, of me, of my personality, of what I wanted to be seen and known for, what I wanted to put out into the world. And it was also, you know, a time for me. So if you know my story, you know, I started in network marketing and online business about a year after my mom passed away. And so that was a really pivotal time for me that, you know, one chapter, a very huge, important chapter of my life was closing and had closed. And I wanted to start this new chapter in a way that felt really good for me because I had that year of grieving and of, you know, just, I guess, grief, this year of grief where I didn't know who I was. I did not know myself at all. And so I really was craving building that brand identity. And as I have learned even more through my business, through personal development, and really just exploring all of the possibilities and options that are out there, my brand has grown and evolved so much. And I still see like this vision on where it is going as well. Like I am not evolved to the point where I want to be even yet currently. So, you know, you get to really create a brand that authentically resonates with you, with your target audience, with what sort of impact you want to create. And I definitely believe that you can be partnered with network marketing companies that feel super aligned with this. And a lot of them sometimes will really supplement and add to your personal brand, but they are not your personal brand, right? They are not you. And so what can be you though are programs and products and services that you create. So for example, my Confident and Ambitious Mastermind that I created is me 100%, right? I'm confident, I'm ambitious, I'm a go-getter, I talk branding, I want to build a community of women who supports each other and we, you know, rise to the top together and that is what we're doing. That is me. And no one can take that feeling that I have curated in that container away from me and away from that container. And so that's what I'm saying by building something that is your own with your unique brand identity tied into it. Another reason, it's just diversifying your income streams. Like, why not add a business on to your full-time job, to your network marketing company, to have something else? Because, okay, let's just be real right now. There are risks when you're relying solely on one income stream, whether that income stream is through a 9-to-5, you know, corporate type job, or whether that income stream is in network marketing. Because again, you are not in control of that company at all. So I have seen so many companies go under, so many companies switch their compensation plans, so many companies completely wipe out their independent consultants who have helped them grow to where that they are. And then you're just basically SOL, right? Like you're out of luck. You're out of luck, my friend, if that ends up happening. Same thing with jobs. You know, people have layoffs. We had COVID and that completely changed the workplace for so many people. So diversifying your income streams, whether that is through, real estate investing, like literally anything where you can add on multiple ways that you can be bringing money in at all times, just the financial benefits and the security of that alone, but especially the security of it when you know that those are your products and services. You're the one who is the control of, you're in control of if you launch it next month, if you tweak it next month, if you do a sale, you know, if you add something in extra, if you decide to add in one-on-one coaching, if you decide to raise your class size from 15 students to 30, if you decide to move from a one-on-one model to a small group model, all those are your decisions. And there's so much freedom in that and independence in that and security in that. And along with that, you know, I think one of the things that can be really difficult for people to imagine is how to balance your own thing plus network marketing or plus your full-time job. Hello, I'm the queen of that. If you have not met me, my name is Lindsay Dollinger and I'm the queen of productivity and systems. So you can go back and find a million podcast episodes I've created on, you know, for that. I have a freebie downloadable on my website that is like your daily business checklist. Run through that and stay consistent with that, with those simple basics. And I guarantee you that you will be able to balance them, you know, your network marketing and your own business or your own business full-time job, or heck, just your own business in life in general. I guarantee if you download that freebie, it will help you out a ton of time. Okay. Another reason, start your own business. Establish your authority and expertise, because creating your own products and building your own business, it establishes you as an authority in your niche. We all have something that we are an expert at, that you are more expert at than someone else as well. So, you know, use that, use your ability to do whatever that thing is and share that with people, monetize it. Now, I don't think you have to monetize everything. That's another discussion for another day as well. But I do believe that you can pick something that you are passionate about, that you want to make an impact in, and that you are good at, position yourself as that expert, and continue to excel in your full-time job, in your network marketing business. Again, hello, that's 100% what I have done with my coaching business. You know, I started creating smaller courses, like smaller, more bite-sized courses for network marketers. I added my planner and tracker in. I started with one-on-one coaching. I added my podcast. Everything has been a very natural progression. I had my membership for 3 years, and then I launched my mastermind this past year. And so everything, again, has been like a very natural progression that I have been able to position myself as this expert business coach because of my years of experience, because I have started the email list, started the podcast, started the membership, had the successful network marketing business where I went to the top, you know, all of those things. But if I hadn't started doing those things, if I hadn't said like, yes, I am a, you know, top network marketer, top 1% network marketer. Yes, I am a course creator. I never would have got to the point where I felt expert enough to start my mastermind. So if you don't start positioning yourself as those things now, you're never going to get there. So, you know, you just got to start. You just got to start. And along those lines, if you are, as I'm thinking about this, and I will remind you, because we're almost done with the episode, you know, I like to keep things short, sweet, to the point. But I do have a freebie on my website. I believe it's called How to Create a Business I Love to Leave My 9-to-5. I'm going to put a little asterisk here because I don't think that you have to leave your 9-to-5 in order to create the business you love, but that's an excellent freebie. It's like about a 15-minute training, and then there's like a, some worksheets to work through with that. And when you go through that, that will help you decide what sort of business that might be right for you to create, because that's another question that I know you're probably going to ask is like, okay, this sounds great. You've talked me into it. I definitely want to add my own thing to my network marketing business, or I definitely want to add my own thing or start my own business. I have no idea where to start. Start with that freebie. So I'll make sure to link that below, but it's just, if you go to lindsaydollinger.com/freebies or just lindsaydollinger.com, you'll see the freebies tab there at the top. You will see what I'm talking about over there. Okay. And then the last reason I think that you should start your own business that is truly, truly, truly your own is to overcome some challenges and embrace the growth. There is something super magical that has happened to me as I have stepped into my role as being an entrepreneur. And as I have stepped into the role of being an entrepreneur solely on my own, a solopreneur, one that is not attached to a company, an affiliate program, anything like that. And I know there's a lot of imposter syndrome that will come up most likely as you start to do this, myself included. I still have those moments where, you know, where I do that. Or I have those moments where I look at my podcast and I'm like, oh my gosh, how have I recorded over 300 episodes of that show? Like, what do I even have to talk about? You know, we're human. We allow those thoughts to creep into our head. But there's something so powerful and so rewarding about overcoming those challenges and showing up really big. And then, you know, having that woman send you the message and say like, hey, I really love your podcast. I don't know if you know this, but you've really inspired me to do XYZ. Or have someone come up to you in the Costco line. That's happened. Or the Costco aisle. Some woman found me from an aisle over and she was like, oh my gosh, I recognized your voice. I wanted to come say hi. So it's just a really, really cool thing to have that happen and just to realize, and it might not happen for a while, friends. Like you might not have that person come up to you in Costco for 3 years, but blinders on. Show up for yourself, because at the end of the day, you're the one that deserves your own business. You're the one who deserves to have the freedom that you desire, the income that you desire, the creativity outlet that you desire, the thing that is your own that you desire. Like, you deserve that. So why not do it? Embrace the growth, embrace the messiness of it. You know, find the right support. Manage your time wisely so that you're not like, okay, well, who has time to add another business? I'm already doing 18 million things in my network marketing business. No, friend. We got to manage our time a little bit better. Because especially if you have a network marketing business and if you're doing it the right way, building a brand, you're making connections, you're creating content anyway, adding your own thing into your personal brand should be super easy. And that's also why I am obsessed with making sure that you have a strong personal brand, that you have something that you're passionate about and that you're sharing that with people, that your content is at least semi-strategic and you're talking about things that have to do with your business or have to do with your passions and are attracting the right people to you. Because it has been super natural for me over the years, once I have gotten this nailed down, to add my business coaching to my network marketing business, add my podcast to that, add my membership to that, add my one-on-one coaching to that, add my mastermind to that. It's just been a very natural journey if you are growing your personal brand and really focusing on that in a way that is supportive of you and your future businesses. So embrace it. Embrace the change, embrace the challenges, embrace the growth. And when you do that, I think you're going to create something that is your own, that you are so proud of, that you are so freaking obsessed with, and that no one can take from you, which is super key to me. I want that security. I want to know that something is mine, and I don't want anyone telling me what to do. I just don't. I straight up don't. So those are some of the things and reasons that I'm obsessed with having my own business, and I would love to encourage you to do the same thing. So if you loved this episode, make sure you head to my website for those freebies that I mentioned, the daily business checklist for sure. Also the training that I have on how to create a business you love to leave your 9 to 5. Those are huge. I have some other freebies on there as well, depending on where you're at in your business journey. So if you have already maybe started something on the side, maybe you haven't, or you know, you're in network marketing, you want to scale that, I have all sorts of stuff on there for you. Additionally, I want to let you know that the waitlist is now open. The doors are opening literally so soon. I am so excited for my new all-inclusive business course that I've been creating. My mastermind women have been getting first access to the trainings, have been letting me know what kind of trainings they want added to it. So things are getting added all the time. I already have like 50 modules though. So it's literally so much information. It's anything that you could ever want. I was going to call it the business buffet. And then I'm like, I'm working on my health and fitness journey. I feel like that's kind of triggering. But that's kind of the concept, is that you can go in and pick and choose what you need for you and your business at that time, whether you're a baby business just starting out from idea, or you're established and you want to know how to, you know, use Facebook more effectively. There's trainings on that. So my new business course is called Purpose to Profits Dream Business Academy. Make sure that you get on the waitlist ASAP, because you'll be the first one to know when the doors open. You'll also get an exclusive discount, which I'm super excited about. And it's going to be freaking amazing. So reach out to me. Let me know if this has inspired you to start your own thing, or maybe you only already have your own thing. I want to know what that is, because I want to cheer you on, because you know, what goes wrong when we cheer other women on for their hopes and dreams. All right. Talk to you soon, friend.